Hi all, welcome to the admin functionality training video. So in this admin functionality training video, we are going to cover the users tab today and all the functions that happen on the users tab. As you can primarily see, the users tab gives you a list of all the users that are registered on the platform and the different roles in which they are registered. So moving on, if we take one sample user, in this case, coolteach@sharklasers.com is registered with us as a teacher. As soon as we click on the edit button, we get to see all the details about the user, the name, the email or phone with which they registered with us, and the role in which they are registered, and the grade or exams in which they are registered for. So we have the first option to reset the password of a user. We can click on reset password, we can enter the new password and click on save. So what happens over here is a confirmation is sent to the user's registered email saying that the password is reset. So they can again log in as with the new password in such a way that their new password will be effective. So sometimes when this is very helpful, when the teacher or the student lose their password, or for some reason their password gets deactivated or they forget their password, the admin can go in and reset the password for them. Or also another situation where a password is reset is when a teacher needs to be moved to a different role. There are different situations in which this can happen, because the teacher can become the center head, the center head can become the principal. So in all these situations, what happens is, even in the application, their role needs to change, and we don't want to create a new user every single time. That's why I have given an option to edit the role of a user and move him or her to the next level. So when the teacher is hired or promoted to a center head, we don't want to create a new account again for the same teacher, because the teacher's information is already there on the platform. So we are simply going to edit the role and say that the same teacher with the same name, same email ID has been moved to a different role as a center head. So when we click on save, what happens is the user has moved to a new role called center head. As you can see over here, the change will be reflected over here. Initially, when we saw this teach, under teach, we saw teacher, which was the name of the role. Now the role is moved to center head. So that is the first thing that we would do in the users tab in admin account. The second thing, as we saw, was the reset password. The third thing that we have on the users tab is the ability to filter the records, and we can only see the number of directors registered on the platform. We can see the center head. So this is one of the other features which helps us see the list of teachers or center heads in the account. Then we also have the search button, in which we can enter the name and search the user. The other thing that you see over here is the new user. What happens is, in the white label solution, we have not given the option to the user to sign up. So the sign up always happens from the back end by the admin, no matter whether it is a student or the teacher. Everybody is created by the admin. So that is why it's important for us to be able to enter all the details, like the name, the email, the role, and the grade or exams for which they are registered. So once they sign up, the same thing follows. They go ahead and the user ID and password is communicated to them, and they can go and go in and they can sign up, they'll go in and log in into their account. An option to change the password is available for them in two places, one on the login screen and also the other one in the profile page. So to sum it all up, this is basically what we cover in the user functionality. Please feel free to get back to us with questions. Thank you so much for watching the video. Bye.